After trying to cycle around Manhattan, following the shorelines many times through 2019-2020, I realized that Manhattan is always under construction, prompting many detours from shoreline. The Waterview Bike Path in the upper northeast part of Manhattan has been closed for what seems like forever. I still want to cycle a full lap around Manhattan. I start this lap at the back entrance to the Queensboro Bridge on East 60th and 1st Avenue, heading uptown on the 1st Avenue bike path. This dedicated bike path is just 2 blocks away from the East River. Make a left turn onto a bike line on East 119th Street. This shared bike line takes us west. Some parts of the road don't have clear bike line markings, just stay on a straight line as it goes. Make a right turn onto a bike line on St. Nicholas Avenue going uptown. Stay on St. Nicholas Avenue following the bike lane. It is actually a nice bike lane with some pretty sights. Stay on St. Nicholas Avenue. Some intersections are a bit confusing. Just ride in the same direction staying on St. Nicholas Avenue. Oh, that was close. Hate those doors opened in my face. Broadway meets with St. Nicholas Avenue on West 169th Street. Stay on your right on St. Nicholas Avenue. The road goes uphill in this part of Manhattan as we cycle in a counterclockwise direction around Manhattan. I actually prefer to ride around Manhattan in this direction on my Boardwalk single-speed 20-inch bike for a simple reason. St. Nicholas Avenue dissolves into Fort George Avenue on West 193rd Street, basically at the highest point of a hill that I have not mastered going up in the opposite direction yet. Move left from Fort George Avenue across the sidewalk on the bike lane of Fort George Hill. Here starts a breathtaking drop downhill. Test your brakes before attempting. I am taking it with both hands on the bar, cannot hold camera now. The pass down the Fort George Hill brings us to the intersection of Nagel Avenue and Dyckman Street. Take the bike path on Dyckman Street going west. A short ride brings us under the Henry Hudson Parkway. Make a left turn and take the bike path going up the ramp. Up we are going. Enjoy a view of George Washington Bridge from the top of the ramp. I am taking a bike path in the south direction on my bike, you can see here. This bike path goes along the Hudson River all the way to the south of Manhattan and then up the north by the East River. Basically, it goes all the way around the city, save the northeast part where it is interrupted by construction and such. The bike path turns right as we approach the George Washington Bridge. Down the hill we are going through an arch. And here we are under George Washington Bridge. I am going to make a stop on the south side of the bridge. The next time around I will show you the view from the bridge. Yeah, that is for the next trip. For now we keep pedaling south following the bike path along the Hudson River. a short ride from the bridge you will find Sisyphus stones. Take your time to add one of yours. There are many Gison fields, art installations, and the bike path winding on and on. Some parts of the path along the Hudson River are reserved only for pedestrians. Cyclists must take a detour. After a short detour, we are back on a speedy straight line bike path. There are many attractions to stop by or just look at on your way through. The Intrepid is one of them. As we zoom through Chelsea, a view of a little island park construction opens onto 55th Pier. It looks promising. There is so much for our eyes to rest on. The bike path winds around Battery Park, bringing us to the South Ferry Station. Here is the South Ferry Station. We are going in the north direction by the East River Bikeway, passing Seaport, iconic Brooklyn Bridge, followed by the Manhattan Bridge. I have to stop between those two bridges to enjoy the view. Couples dancing, it is so nice here. The Williamsburg Bridge is ahead. There are nice parks with beautiful views of the East River. I turn left from this bike path onto East 35th Street. Here I ride one short block to First Avenue. The First Avenue bike path is across the street. Here I make a right turn onto the bike path heading north. Fly by the UN's box-shaped building. Go straight to the Queensboro Bridge on 60th Street and 1st Avenue. It is the same place where we started this trip. Congratulations! We completed about 30 miles long full lap around Manhattan in under 3 hours time, mostly following along the shorelines. Check my Strava for more details about this and my other rides, links in the description. Have fun and happy cycling!